A gay mayoral candidate found dead in Mississippi. It's a state, of course, known for its more conservative politics. Marco McMillan had big plans for Clarksdale. That was his hometown of just about 17,000 people. Take a look. That's him in the red tie, standing next to President Obama. This is just from a couple of years ago. He was only 34 years old, a Democrat, considered a rising star in politics. But on Tuesday, police say a man crashed McMillan's SUV into another car. McMillan's body, not in the car, but found miles away near a Mississippi River levee. Nick Valencia is with me here in studio. And just sort of, can you help me fill in the blanks here? Is anyone in custody? What more do we know?
Well, they have a person of interest, but he's not been formally charged at this point. He was in Brian McMillan's car on Tuesday, at which point he was driving on the highway, and he veered into oncoming traffic, crashed into another car. Police arrived. They searched Brian McMillan's vehicle, realizing that he was missing, at which point they started conducting this search, and they found his body in a levee, in a Mississippi River levee, on Wednesday. Now, Brooke, there's a lot of speculation, a lot of mystery surrounding Brian McMillan's death. Sure. I spoke to one of his fraternity brothers earlier today. They described him as someone being very professional. They say that he was out and gay to certain members, but this isn't something that defined him. He wasn't running as the gay candidate in Clarksdale, Mississippi. He just happened to be gay, and this is part of his character. In fact, listen to what his mother had to say to us. We've got a full screen for you here. She said, he did not announce in public that he was gay. And I don't think that he was attacked because he was gay. This coming to us from Patricia McMillan, Marco's mother. We didn't even know him. We never heard of him. He wasn't a friend on his Facebook page. Marco didn't know him either. That comes from the stepfather of Brian McMillan. Now, he's been characterized as a rising star, Brooke, and he was named as top 30 under 30 by Ebony magazine. But in terms of this mayoral race, he wasn't a front runner. In fact, he wasn't favored to win at all. He was running against several other candidates, one being the son of a former mayor, but he did touch the lives of a lot of people, and a lot of people have been very impacted by this. In fact, the fraternity brother that I spoke to, Brooke, said that Brian never met a stranger.